What is going on, everybody? This is Mike with Terrible Gaming, and today I just wanted to give you guys my general layout for how I like to set up Malthael while I'm playing as him in Heroes of the Storm, and just kind of give you just an overview of my favorite build. It's probably not the best build that you could do for him, but it's the best build that I've come up with. And pretty much how this build works is it's more of a dive build. Like, you're going to be diving in and trying to deal as much damage as possible. You'll probably, if you end up going with this build, you'll probably die quite a bit because you'll be jumping into combat a lot. But it's going to be focused more on marking enemies with the Reaper's Mark and healing with the Soul Rip. And it has some, you know, it's tracking down enemies and kind of singling them out. But overall, it's built for more large areas and damaging multiple enemies at once. So we'll go ahead and we'll jump right in. Okay, so for the level 1 ability, I generally like to take the Death's Reach ability that increases the Wraith Strike by 35%. It's really nice for if you have somebody that's trying to escape and you've already marked them, and you can kind of solo them out and just, you know, hunt them down a little bit. And see right here, you'll see this is how I normally just like kind of jump into battle and try and do as much healing and mark as many people as possible. Early game, it's not as important. Like right here, it's not as important to mark everybody. You're not going to be dealing like crazy amounts of damage. You won't be getting crazy amounts of healing, but it's still fun to kind of jump in and do some damage. And then for level 4, I normally do the Black Harvest that applies Reaper's Mark, or it's a quest where you have to apply Reaper's Mark to people for a total of 150 seconds. And the reward is that you permanently increase Reaper's Mark duration by 2 seconds, which is really, it's one of the cornerstones of this build, to really get the maximum efficiency out of it. Because that Reaper's Mark, it deals percentage-based damage, so you'll just melt through tanks. And the lasting longer down the road with other traits will do a lot more for you. And then for level 7, I generally do the Soul Rip slows enemies by 20% for 2.5 seconds. Just because later on in the build, it'll be really useful, because I use Soul Rip a lot. It's my number one ability that I use with him, just because obviously it heals you and deals a decent amount of damage in an area. And then level 10, so a lot of people would go with Last Rites, I think, but I generally like to go with the Tormented Souls. And that's this ability right here. It makes you mark everybody around you. So if you didn't already complete your quest, it'll be real easy at this point to complete it, especially if you're diving in and trying to mark everybody at once. It'll generally make people scatter too, which is nice. They won't want to be anywhere near you because they're just going to be taking quite a bit of heat. And also, it what's nice too is it marks all the minions as well, so you could be healing off of those with your Soul Rip. And the Soul Rip too, once we get a little bit further into the talent trees, Soul Rip is going to be ending up doing more healing and stuff like that, which is really important. So this next level 13 ability, I normally do the Soul Siphon, which is what I was just talking about. It increases the amount of healing you get. So if you watch right here, you can see that just the crazy amounts of healing that I'm doing. And there's not a ton of stuff that they can do about it. Especially since right now I just completed my quest. So the Reaper's Mark is lasting 6 seconds now as opposed to 4. So not only are you dealing extra damage, but it's giving you more time to do the Soul Rip. And then right here, I normally do... which one is it? The Wraith Strike now, no, I'm sorry. I normally do the Reaper's Mark deals 100% extra damage after 4 seconds. Duh, obviously. That's one of the main ones that I do in this. And so now you'll see how it looks like it's doing critical damage to that Diablo. That's just because it's been on him for longer than 6 seconds. And with the quest being complete, anytime I mark anybody, it automatically does 6 seconds. So, oh no, I'm sorry, it deals extra damage if it's over 4 seconds. So every time I hit somebody with the Reaper's Mark or with any basic attack, they're automatically going to be taking that that extra damage. And right here, for level 20, I almost always pick the instantly return from death. It's called No One Can Stop Death. I normally take that one just because it's nice to be able to jump in and just, you know, respawn yourself at your convenience, pretty much. Only thing is that you have to remember is it reduces your next, or it increases your cooldown for your next respawn by 25%, which could be kind of a problem. And yeah, and so to, like how we end all terrible gaming videos, I lost this round. But, you know, regardless, Malthael's still a very good character. He has a lot of really good abilities, and if you do this build and you kind of dive in more, and you're doing all those marks and stuff, you'll almost always end up with this situation where I had like, what is it, 140,000 hero damage. This was like an exceptionally long match, so I did have a little extra time, but I almost always have most hero damage just because you're just diving in, you're dealing percentage based damage, you're soul ripping, and gaining all that life back. So it's pretty powerful, especially if you're a good Heroes of the Storm player, which I am not. So for somebody that's a little more experienced in this game, or a little more skilled in this game, could probably pull that off a little bit better. But overall, that's my favorite build for this. Sorry, it got a little rambly there for a second, but that's just kind of like how I like to construct this character. I've tried a bunch of different ways. I've tried doing last rites, and I've tried doing other abilities. I just didn't like them as much. You can ask Dirk, or you can go watch our other videos. I like to dive in and, you know, risk my health to try and get some damage in. And so this build kind of suits my needs. But let me know if you guys have a different build, if you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe to our channel for more content. And until next time, I've been Mike with Terrible Gaming, and you have yourself a terrible day. Thank you so much for watching and supporting our channel. If you enjoyed this video, click right here for our latest upload, or click right here for another episode. And click our channel icon in the middle to subscribe.